I'm Kevin Cameron, one of your Marion County Commissioners, and I'm here with Jessica Ramey, who is a Waste Reduction Coordinator with Marion County Environmental Services. Welcome,
Thank
Jamie.
You.
It's Jessica. It's great to have you here with us today. And we're here to talk about the Master Recycling Program that Marion County offers. I have a little bit of personal experience with that. I actually signed up and took the class last year. Had a great experience for that. So you're going to have to be really honest with me and tell me about the program, because I'll know all the answers.
You will.
To the questions
you'll grill me.
that we're talking about here. Well, why don't you just tell us a little bit about the background of the Master Recycling class?
Absolutely. So it started in 1994. We had one waste reduction coordinator at the time, Terry Freistad. And he learned of a program that was starting in Seattle. So he decided to look into it. He checked out the program and realized that he could adapt that for Marion County. And since then, now we have about 8 different programs throughout the state. And part of that program is paying back 30 hours of volunteer payback hours. Mm-hmm. And it's been really beneficial to the county. We've had about 8,000 hours tracked. And it's probably more than that, because people have a hard time reporting their hours. But that equals about 3.5 years of a full-time position. So
yeah. One of the things I learned, and you asked me before we even started this interview, what was some of the highlights for me. But one of the things, I think the program is almost misnamed, and then it's Master Recycling, and
right. It's
really talking and helping us talk about reduction, reusing, and then recycling if possible.
Absolutely.
So there's the 3 R's that we learned in that class. What are some of the topics that we go over in the Master Recycling class?
Right, so it really gets into the nitty-gritty details of solid waste in general, and we do really emphasize the reduction and the reusing parts of that. We also talk about what happens when you put it out your bin. Where does it go in the end? A lot of people in Marion County believe that it goes to a landfill, and the majority of it does not. So people get to go on field trips. They get to go to the waste-to-energy facility to learn more. And we get to learn about composting, worm composting, what to do with styrofoam. There's a lot, and also engaging with the community and learning what the community has to offer, because there's a lot of opportunities out there.
Yeah, it was a great experience. In fact, yesterday I was just at one of our transfer stations dropping off Christmas lights. I didn't even know that I could recycle old Christmas lights.
Right.
I learned that in the class.
Absolutely. Anything with a plug can definitely be recycled through the e-waste program.
Right. So one of the things about the class that I thought was really educational was the field trips. Can you tell us a little bit about the field trips if you sign up for this class?
Absolutely. That was, I think, my favorite part too. I took the class in 2012 before I even had this position with Marion County, and I think that was the most fun. The one I enjoyed the most was going to the waste to energy facility. I don't know if you recall and if you went to that, but
3 times I've been.
Oh, it was so great, because it seemed like an interesting, like 1970s set of Star Trek kind of thing. But you really got to see what was happening and all the work that takes place to make that happen, as well as going to the ash afterwards and see that only 10% of that material is left over from everything that we haul into the waste to energy. Mm-hmm. So it was good to see the behind the scenes of that. Yeah. But there's quite a few that we go to. Agroplast, which people can recycle agricultural waste there, or their plastics. There's a styrofoam densifier that you could see at the Fresh Start Market. So if people want to get rid of their styrofoam, there's a place to take it now. There's so many different places. A newspaper facility, which people aren't printing newspapers very much anymore. Right. But we are lucky enough to go to one of those. So there's so much.
The burner was, I got to do that twice before the field trip that we went on. But I think one of the things that, and you even said 10% of the ash, today with the new equipment that's in the burner, the ash is taken on a daily basis. It's interesting that you learn this on the field trip, and now that ash is going daily over to Benton County,
right,
to Coffin Butte, which is their landfill, and they use it daily to cover up their landfill. So
exactly,
100% of it is now being used for something and not just piled up.
Yeah, and there's even a request for proposal out there for people that have even more innovative ideas to make concrete and other different things with it too.
So who would you say is the normal person that takes the class? Who would you encourage to take the class, or who has taken the class in the past?
Absolutely. So right now we have a lot of retired people that take it, but also a lot of people that are participating in their green teams in their businesses. So a lot of business owners will pay for their employee to be sent for the training, which is great. But we've also had AmeriCorps students and mm-hmm. college students participate as well, stay-at-home parents. So it's really neat to see a really big, broad mix of people mm-hmm. take it.
Actually, a gentleman from Republic Services was in our class with us, who was actually one of the garbage haulers.
Right.
He was there. But I think one category you left out of people who should go to this class or have gone to this class is actually Marion County Commissioners.
Absolutely. We love that.
Yeah, right.
We were so thrilled that you took it.
Yeah. Well, and that's one of the things just that I want to know more and more about what Marion County offers, not only in the environmental services areas, but in our health department. So I'm going out and trying to take a lot of those programs, and that's one of the reasons I did that. So where could people find out more about when the class is offered and what that entails?
Great. So people can go to our website, masterrecycler.net, to learn more information about when it's going to be. We are actually mixing it up this year. We are going to be offering it in the daytime on Thursdays mm-hmm. from 8 to 4. So what people will do is they'll attend the class and then do the field trips in the later time in the daytime. So usually they're on Thursday nights, but not. We found that not everybody could attend Thursday evening, so we're really trying to make it a little bit more flexible for people. So that will start in September and then end October, and it's 5 classes, so it's really doable. It's really affordable. It's $25, and people will have a lot of fun.
So the time period shrunk down. The classes are longer, obviously.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So some people that have the time during the day, maybe their business is going to allow them to do that, to learn this,
absolutely.
And be able to take it. And if there's those of you that are watching and say, well, I can't take a Thursday class, mm-hmm. I'm sure the class will be offered again in the evening at some point in time out in
absolutely.
The future.
Absolutely, and we do have a sign-up list. So if mm-hmm. say you can't take it this time around, if you sign up on masterrecycler.net, we just keep track of it and send it out when those are available.
Great. One of the things I really appreciate about taking the class is the emails that I get now mm-hmm. all the time from environmental services. And one of the give backs is that after you take the class, and in fact, Commissioner Brentano asked me if I has graduated, and I guess I haven't officially graduated because I have to put in 30 hours
right.
of volunteer work. And
even
I just,
commissioners have to
yes,
do that.
Yes, we can't get away with that. And I just got to spend 4 hours in the Save Our Food booth
right.
That we just, I think, is you're hearing about on this tape today at the Marion County Fair. And that was a great experience that I got to engage with people and educate them. And one of the things that we can talk about here is to make sure that people know about Save Our Food and go to the website and sign up to take the pledge.
Absolutely. So the savethefood.net is the website to visit mm-hmm. for that. It's really simple. You just click on the things that you're going to commit to do. And then it'll also sign you up for giveaways and emails. We send out monthly emails to educate and further offer tips.
Yeah, another thing that I appreciated about the class, because I live in rural Marion County. Mm-hmm. I think about maybe last year or the year before, got the blue container where we can put our mixed recyclables in
right.
there. But the composting part of it, mm-hmm. maybe tell us a little bit about some of the field trips that teach us about composting. I think there was a couple field trips when I was there.
Absolutely. So there are places that you can go that actually teach you worm composting too, mm-hmm. which is really exciting. And I just took a weekend class this weekend about that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a master recycler who's teaching it. And it's really great, just about how much worms can compost.
Well, you know what I'd use the worms for?
Oh, fishing.
Oh, absolutely.
And I heard the red wigglers are great for that too. So while they're eating them and they're getting all fat and juicy, then you can use them later for fishing.
Yeah. I thought it was pretty amazing that I said, okay, where do I get the worms to start? And somebody says, well, they just show up.
Sometimes they do.
Yep.
And if you're not so lucky, you can go back and visit Bert and Mona and they'll take care mm-hmm. of you. I just got a pound of them and they'll eat about 3 pounds of food a week. So that's quite a bit.
Wow.
Yeah.
So other ways that people who live out in the rural areas, besides worm composting, we actually got to tour a place, I think it was over at Bush Park, where there's some different examples of
absolutely.
Composting bins and how you can do that in your own backyard.
Yes, we have another demonstration area at the Oregon Gardens as well. And so it's a really good place to see different lasagna gardening and composting as well. So
again, so I'm going to share just a little bit about, I've been a county commissioner now a little over a year. And one of the things that I think that Marion County citizens can be very proud of, and I give the credit to Commissioners Brentano and Commissioners Carlson, and even maybe prior to them, is our burning, our burn to energy. Nowhere else in Oregon does anybody do that. And I know that I've been misquoted, and so I may be misquoted again today, but since the last year or so, we go back and forth between number one and number two in the state in actually recycling or reducing the amount of waste that goes into our waste system. And that goes in is burned in energy. Currently, I know our Public Environmental Services is looking at other ways to have the ash be used for other products.
Right.
Do you know anything about that and what that process is looking like?
We got some feedback back about that, and I wasn't involved with that project, but it looks like it's going back to a request for proposals to get more ideas.
Yeah, so if we could find, besides the daily cover out using it at another landfill, if we could find some use, whether that's for roads or bricks or something like that, we would have 100% of our waste actually being consumed, reused,
absolutely,
into energy.
Well, and that's what's so great about the Master Recycling class, is it really does link people that have needs and wants all together in the same place that are thinking very green. So for instance, we had somebody from Kerr Concentrates take the class, and they realized that we have a paint recycling program. But before, we were purchasing or getting these buckets from elsewhere. And they have these buckets because they are processing fruit and whatnot, and they can't reuse it since it has to be food grade. So they connected with us and said, hey, we can give you those for free. We're gonna donate them. So it's all these connections of people knowing other people and networking to find these solutions, because they're not just throwaway materials anymore. They really can be resources.
So you mentioned the paint recycling. How does a citizen of Marion County get that paint that we recycle, and what does it cost them?
Well, it's free, and people can go to the transfer station and pick it up. It comes in about a 5-gallon bucket, and it's a beautiful gray. It's a nice warm gray color. When I opened our nonprofit, we actually painted our walls with that, and it was a great solution.
Fantastic. Do you hear that? You can get free paint at our transfer center, which is out off of Gaffin Road,
right? Absolutely.
Right, okay. Well, I want to say thank you very much for the service that you provide to Marion County citizens, and for sharing with us about the Master Recycling Program. It's one of the most fun things and educational things I've done as a Marion County Commissioner outside my day-to-day job. So we just want to encourage you today to sign up for the Marion County Master Recycling class. Know that the class is from September 10th to October 8th on Thursdays, all day on Thursdays. It's a great class. You'll learn a lot. And then you get to give back and serve in various ways, like I just did at the Marion County Fair for 4 hours. You need to serve for 30 hours. That there's a way you can educate your neighborhood, have
Absolutely.
All kinds of activities in your neighborhood. But we want to thank you for watching this program. Remember, Save Our Food is important. Go to the website, sign the petition to commit yourself to do better at saving your food. And we just thank you for watching tonight or today, and we'll see you on our next CCTV program. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I am a master recycler.
I'm a master recycler.
I am a master recycler.
I am a master recycler.
I'm a master recycler.
I'm a master recycler.
I'm a master recycler.
I am a master recycler.
Over 670 people have taken the Marion County Master Recycling class to learn about waste reduction, recycling, composting, and consumption. Become part of the team and join the movement today. Visit masterrecycler.net.